Hello everyone, I am Professor S. N. Mane, Assistant Professor, Department of Processing and Food Engineering, working in KKWA College of Agriculture Engineering and Technology, Nashik. Today we will learn about food adulteration and the food safety. So first of all, we will see what is mean by food adulteration. An adulterant, it is a chemical substance which should not be contained within other substances for legal or other reasons. The addition of adulterant, it is called as an adulteration. Now the word is appropriate only when the additions are unwanted by that recipients. Otherwise the expression would be as a food additives. Okay, we said it as an food additives. Suppose it is unwanted, in that condition we said it is a adulterants. Now adulterants, when it is used in the illicit drugs, are called as a cutting agents, while deliberate addition of the toxic adulterants to the food or other products for the human consumption, then it is known as a poisoning. So these are different terms related to the addition of the chemical substance which is other than the main food products. Okay, now we will see a proper definition of this food adulteration. See, it is an act of intentionally debasing the quality of food offered for the sale, either by admixture or substitution of inferior substances or by the removal of some valuable ingredient. So here we are intentionally adding or we are dispersing the quality of that food products which are used for the sale purpose. We are mixturing or we are making the substitution for that main food product by the inferior substances. And we are reducing the value of that particular food products by mixing the other substance which is not valuable. Now, also we will say, we will take the another definition like also we called as it is an addition of another substance to a food item in order to increase the quantity of that food item in the raw form or in the finished form. Now, which may resulted into the loss of the actual quality of the food item. See here, we are increasing the quantity of our main product by adding the another inferior quality substance. Okay. So in each form, in the raw form or in the finished form, you can add or increase the quantity of that food item. Now we will see some act related to the food adulteration. Now the prevention of food adulteration bill, it was passed by both the House of the Parliament and it is received as an assent of the President on 29 September 1954. But it is came into the force in the 1st June 1955 as the Prevention of Food Adulteration Act 1954. Now, in this act, we will see some terms, adulterant and adulterated. Now, adulterant means what? Any material which is or could be get employed for the purpose of adulteration. Okay, and adulterated means what? An article of the food, it shall be deemed to be adulterated, means main food product which we get adulterated, okay, which get their quality may get destroyed, okay, or get disturbed. And adulterant means any material or any substance which is added or which is used to be for destroying their or disturbing the quality of main food product. Okay, now we will see how we can say a particular food is get adulterated. Okay, so the article sold by a vendor, it is not of the nature, substance or the quality demanded by the purchaser. See, first of all, that article or the kind of food which is sold by the vendor, which is not having the quality or nature or the substance which is demanded by your purchaser. Then article contains any other substance which affecting the nature, substance or the quality. Then cheaper or the inferior substance which has to be substituted. Then article had been prepared, packed, or kept under the insanitary condition. So there may be the chances to become contaminated or injury to our health. And the article consists wholly or partially. The filthy, putrid, or the rotten, or animal infected, or the disease infected, or insect infested substances, which is unfit for the human consumption. Then article which is coming from the diseased animals. So all these things which are responsible for saying adulterated food. Then sometimes some poisonous or other ingredient which may get enter in your food material and which is injurious to the health. Then coloring matter other than your prescribed, it is present in the food material. And their concentration, okay, their level, it is also specific, but it is not occurs in the permitted level. So in that condition also you can say your food product, it may get adulterated. Now this adulteration, it is classified into quantitative adulteration, qualitative, and the informational. So these some examples, pictures has shown here. See, this is the quantitative adulteration. This one is information. Already on the packaging material, different information has given and your inner product is different. Okay, like that. And qualitative, see, inferior quality substance mixed in superior quality product. So all these things related to the qualitative adulterations. Again, there are different types of food adulteration: intentionally added, incidental added, metallic contamination, then packaging hazards. See, intentional food adulteration means substances like sand, marble chips, stones, then mineral oil, water, it is intentionally added. Then incidental, like pesticide residues, dropping of the insects or rodents and larvae in the food, etc. Then metallic contamination. See, some metal particles like arsenic from the pesticides, then mercury from the effluent, lead from the water, then certain chemicals from the industries. Okay, all these things coming into your food material. And packaging materials. Packaging hazard means which kind of packaging material, like polythene, LDP, HDP, polyvinyl chloride, like these compounds used for the flexible packaging. So all these things, it is indirectly act as a food adulteration. Now we will see some adulterated food into the market, like turmeric, which get adulterated by some metallic yellow colors compounds, which create some carcinogenic and stomach disorder. Then in green chili or in certain green fruit and vegetables, see malachite green colors coloring agent, it is used for getting green color, which also affecting on the carcinogenic disorders. And then mustard seeds and mustard oil. See here, in this kind of mustard seeds, most of the argemoni seeds or the papaya seeds are mixed as an adulterant. So it will create some epidemic dropsy and severe glaucoma in your body parts. Then mustard seeds. See here, mustard seeds and mustard oil, it is mixed with, I have told you that argemoni seeds, see, which are similar in mustard seeds. Then papaya seeds. These are argemoni seeds, okay, which get mixed into your mustard seeds. Then paneer, khova, and condensed milk and milk. Here in the paneer or khova, most of the time starch content it is used, and in milk most of the time adulterant it is the water. So that will create some stomach disorders. Then in ice cream, pepper onion and ethyl acetate, like these kind of chemicals, it is used in the ice cream as an adult for getting a specific color. And pepper onion, it is used as a pesticides, and that's why it causes some diseases affecting to your lungs, kidneys, and the heart. Then next one is the coffee powder. See here in the coffee powder adulterant, it is used as a tamarind seeds powder and the chicory powder, which is similar to the coffee powder. So it will create some diarrhea, stomach disorders and the giddiness. And definitely it also creates some body parts pain. Then see here some common foods and their adulterant has given again, and their detection method also given here. See, in the rice and wheat flour, sometimes stones, then straws, low grade rice, it is mixed up. That can be detected by some visual detection method. Then wheat flour. In the wheat flour, sometimes talc, then chalk powder and tapioca, it is get mixed up. So it can be removed with the help of sprinkling water on that flour. If that bran get floats and wheat get sinks, you will detect easily it is adulterated. Then whole pulses and dal, it is mixed with. See, dal, kesari dal and arhal dals, these are adulterated. And different dyes like metallic yellow color, it is mixed in your pulses. Now this kesari dal, it is pointed out and it is having different shape, like wedge shape. In the vegetables and fruits, we have learned that is different coloring agents like melachite, coloring agent, it is used for getting green color. Then milk, most of the time water, it is mixed, and the starch in the khava and paneer. In detail, we will see the detection methods. See here, in the sugar, chalk powder, white sand and the semolina, it is mixed. Detection method is that sugar get dissolved in the water, but adulterant it won't. Then honey, concentrated sugar solution and jaggery, it is mixed. See here, cotton wick, it is dipped into the honey. When it burns, then it is adulterated. The presence of water, it allows, it will not allow to get burned, and it causes the crackling. Then in vegetable oil, oil castor and arjumori, these kind of things are mixed. In the ghee, sweet potato or the vanaspati ghee, it is mixed. Then in salt, powdered white stone or the chalk powder, it is mixed. So their detection method is that you have to stir the salt in the water. Then we see that salt get mixed in the water, but white powder, it doesn't get dissolved. And it will make some whitish solution that will easily identify adulteration process. Sorry. Then another. Here, whole black pepper, it is sometimes mixed with the papaya seed. So you have to sprinkle water on that. So papaya seed will get float and these pepper seeds will be get sink into that. Then turmeric. We have seen here melachite or the metanil yellow color agent, it is used for that. Then chili powder, it is mixed with the sawdust and color. Now when put in the water, the sawdust will float on the surface and color will run. If the sediments at the bottom, it will gritty. When it is rubbed up, then there we see that there is the presence of brick water. Then coriander powder. So coriander powder, it is mixed with the horse dung powder. If it is mixed with the water, then horse dung powder, it will get floats and coriander powder will be sink. So these are some examples of these food adulterations. And what are their adulterant and what should be the detection test it has given in this lecture. Thank you.